Hi guys, and welcome back to C64 Sunday. I'm Zerfall, and after a week away to be at the World of Commodore 2014 in Mississauga, we're back. This is Fort Apocalyse, game number 81. It had a score of like 8.33 or something like that. It's up to 8.4 now, and it's actually raised in the list a little bit. But we're going to get right into it. Made by Steve Hale, originally the Commodore version was made by Joe Vierra, and it's from 1982 by Synapse Software. I'm also from 1982, but not by Synapse Software. Now, this is a game that I am not good at. This is going to be a relatively short video because, for whatever reason, I don't know if it's the controls or what, I just cannot... I can't do this game. Part of it is, I guess, that I don't know all the little idiosyncrasies. I managed to get three of these guys spawn this time. Sometimes only one spawns. Oh no, it was just that guy was in the way. I mean, I might have an amazing run here, but I'm pretty much screwed right now, unless that missile drops off. Which it did, but they're the biggest pain in the butts, these missiles. See, they'll just frickin' chase you forever. And if you get low to try to take them out... Crap. See, they suddenly start going up! Doesn't make sense. That missile definitely wasn't frickin' that high when we started chasing us, but apparently it can just start heat-seeking every once in a while. Maybe we can hit these guys with some critical drop bombs. No, don't you try to get me with that. Whoa, how's that guy shooting left and right? Alright, let's see. You get lucky, take him out. No, see, what's dumb is that I'm pretty sure that my freaking bullets went into this guy. They weren't killing him. There's another one of them over here, and he definitely needs to die before it's going to be safe for us to... Is that another one? Holy crap. Holy crap! Ugh! Okay. Alright. This side should be safe now. I'm gonna blow up some of these. While we can. There, okay. So, I don't know if it's just... Maybe I don't understand the game well enough to... I don't want to... This bomb keeps dropping from different parts of my helicopter. That's a bit of a pain in the butt too, and sometimes it's hard to just get your helicopter turned the right way for what you're trying to do. Sometimes it'll turn around super easy when you don't want it to, and sometimes when you want it to turn well, it just doesn't do anything. Oh well. So here's the whole point of Fort Apocalyse. We're here to save these guys. Come on in. Boom. Oh, come on, turn around. See, sometimes he turns around too easy. Sometimes it takes freaking forever, and you've got an enemy that's right beside you you're trying to kill. I don't know, I just can't. I can't do well in this game. Got two more guys here to save. I'm gonna take the right-hand path, because I've tried the left-hand path before, and I always die. I don't know if this is really gonna be any different, but... I'm hoping a change is as good as a break, and nothing bad happens here. Alright. So you see my problem is I gotta get down there, and, oh, I didn't get killed, but I got warped somewhere. That bottom square is gonna come up right while I'm in it. I can't get the timing on this at all, I don't know. Most of the games that in the top 100 that I've played I really like. This is one that I just can't get behind, and I guess it's just because I suck at it. I respawn those stupid guys down at the bottom again, but I guess I got my hole already opened up here, I don't care. Except for these missiles can go on off long distance. Alright, let's get out of here. I'll try this again. I don't know, it just seems like the timing doesn't make any sense here. Well, I guess they killed their own helicopter that time, so we'll give the game that. It has friendly fire turned on for the enemies. I don't know, I don't often suck at video games, but I definitely suck at this one. I don't think I'm gonna get past this first level. I really wish I could. You know what? I want to like this game. It reminds me of very much of Chopper Command that we used to play all the time as a kid. Very similar game where you had to go save guys. But I don't know. It's just a lot less playable to me. Come on. Ah. I probably would have had it that time too if it wasn't for the collision of my tail there. Anyways, this game, you know what? Frick, I'm screwed by this guy now. There we go. This game was well received. C64 Games gave this a 10 out of 10 back in 2006. I don't see how someone gave this game a 10 out of 10. I can see giving it a relatively high score if you had good play with it, but the controls are not perfect. This is not a 10 out of 10 game. Lemon 64, like I said, it's 8.4 there right now. It used to be 8.3. Cultboy.com gave this game an 8.67. I don't know why you guys love this game so much. I hope, you know what, leave comments. Tell me why this game is better than I think it is, because I am not having a good time with this game at all. Like, I don't even know why that just happened. I thought I was dodging these lasers down here. Oh, I'm getting warped from side to side. I don't know where I am at all now. This is extra confusing for me. Can I go this way? No, I can't. Get down. Oh, maybe I can. Okay. No, ah. Okay, I know where this is. I know where this is. I don't want to be here. I want to get one of these warps to take me somewhere good. That's not it. That's not it. How do I get this to go warp me somewhere else? There was one that said land here. I want to go to that one. Maybe that left area there would be good. I can't get to it now, though. Or can I? Aha. Come on, kill him. No! Ah! Just when you think you figure out something that's going on, the game kills you. Give me my fuel. I mean, the bonus starts out at a pretty high number, so maybe they expect you to spend a long time exploring this level and taking your time and going through it, but I just keep dying, and I'm gonna sneeze. Hold on. Hopefully I remember to edit that out. So yeah, give me your opinion of this game, because in all honesty, I can't fathom why someone would like this game so much. I have nothing but hard times with it. I can't get past this first level. The timing on that thing's weird. I guess maybe you're supposed to warp. This clearly isn't the one I want to go to. This is just warping me back to the same place over and over again. Okay, here's the one. Maybe I'm gonna get warped away, but I was gonna hope that maybe. Come on, don't bring me back to the same place. I'm hoping that maybe I can kill that stupid jerk. I managed to take him out, perhaps. Okay, he's gone. See, but I'm having trouble turning around. I need to shoot all that dumb stuff there. Oh no, that's not the other place. I don't even know how these are supposed to work. That's the same one again. Ah, crap, ah, crap. Oh boy. You know what? This is probably a game that everyone has a lot of good memories of. I didn't play it when I was a kid. I don't have good memories of it. And in all honesty, I didn't enjoy this game. I would give this game maybe a 6 or a 7. Seven might be a little too high for me. I'm sure if I spent the time and got to know all the little idiosyncrasies of the game, it might be a good game. But at this point in time, I don't have a full Saturday to just drop into this game. So, for me, Fort Apocalypse, top 100 game, I don't know about that. Most of the other games I've played have been better so far. There's been a couple that haven't been, so I guess maybe it should just be lower down on the list. I don't think this should be 81. It should maybe be down in the 90s. I'm Zerfall, thanks for watching, and I hope to catch you on another Sunday.